Hi, Omari. How are you?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing well. Thank you. So, you are the producer of this film.
Yeah, one of many jobs, but yes.
Well, tell me what it's like producing a film.
Well, I guess it just really depends on what level you're producing on. We're independent, you know, pretty much self-funded. You know, we have help here and there, but it's pretty much all on us. So, the majority of it is just figuring out how to make something happen with nothing. You know, it's just really, since this had basically no budget, we paid for it all out of pocket. We really had to figure out, you know, what were going to be interesting locations. We had to make sure we took care of our crew, our cast, you know, we fed them and kept them warm, you know.
Right.
So it was just, I think it's just the logistics of it, you know, made it a challenge, but it's fun. You know, I think we do really well with working with nothing. So, you know, we just try to make sure that everybody was taken care of, and we did it, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't even know that. So independent films, it's really coming all out of your pocket, trying to figure out how to make the resources last and work for your benefit.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that can be challenging.
Oh, it is challenging. It's definitely challenging.
That's like a big challenge right there.
Yeah.
Well, tell me a little bit about Rebirth Films. How did it start? What do you stand for? What would you tell your audience?
Well, Rebirth Films, my partner Alex and I, we started it, a long time ago. I'm not even sure how many years ago. But basically, Rebirth Films is, our motto is, we're changing the world one film at a time. Basically, what we've decided to do is we're very talented individuals, and you know, Dave and God has blessed us this way, and we know that. So we decided, you know, if he gave us his talent, what are we going to do with it? You know, so we decided that everything that we do, we're going to give the glory to God. Now, we kind of decided to do it in a non-traditional fashion. We're doing like a sci-fi horror. So to put a positive spin on that is, you know, it's very different. It's very marketable. So that is basically the foundation of Rebirth Films. You know, we're all about positivity. You know, you can ask anyone. I mean, I'm kind of a no-nonsense kind of guy when it comes to negativity, because I know it's contagious and I know how destructive it is, you know. So we don't go for that, you know. It's just all about good people doing good things and respecting one another, and you know, making good, wholesome films that when you go home, like Alex said, you're going to take something with you. You know, you're going to look at a certain situation or a scenario possibly a little different. You know, you're going to say, wow, you know, I never thought that an addiction could actually have a demon or another type of influence other than just, you know, getting high or getting drunk, you know. So it's just basically changing the world one film at a time.
I love that quote. It's like stuck in my head now.
Yeah, we're gonna make a song. No,
you should. You really should. No negativity here. No negativity here. That could be the next, you know, well, maybe not the next film, but another film that you do about no negativity. Have you thought about that?
Maybe. I don't know. You know, we find somebody to fund it, we might do it.
By the way, since we're on the next film right now, can you tell me any inside secrets, you know? What do you have in the pipeline?
All right. So basically, what we have right now, we got going on, we have two different projects, and they're both in conjunction to this project, as well as our overall arcing story, which is Lost House of Emmett.
Oh, okay.
So the one that we're working on right now, which, you know, I'll go ahead and tell you a little bit, it's called Asylum District. And it kind of picks up somewhat where this one left off at. You know, we continue with Matt, or his character name is James Campbell.
I was wondering about him.
So it continues with him, and we, you know, we see where Mr. Met has helped him out of the funk that he was in. And where he was a very dark place, but Mr. Met needed to help him basically get back on track, because he was gonna really be needed, you know. So we kind of pick up with him, and we show that, you know, Matt's character in particular is a guy who doesn't really believe in angels or demons or God or anything like that, you know.
Okay.
So, but
that's interesting.
He has a change of heart with the next case that he has. Like, he's kind of like a modern day Sherlock Holmes, and he pretty much can solve any crime when it comes to like heinous things. That's what he does. He tracks serial killers, and as he's tracking down these serial killers in this particular next film, he just comes across things that he just very unnatural, you know. So he slowly starts to believe that there is something more to life than what he was taught. Just, you know, good cops take down bad people. That's it, you know. So
yeah.
That's a little bit, just a little teasing.
I like
a little
that.
Teasing.
It gives me something to kind of go off of. I'm excited. I can't wait to know what's going to happen next.
Yeah, it's going to be cool.
So with these different projects that you have going on, I'm sure that in itself is challenging, keeping it all together, you know, making sure everything's aligned, the funding, all that good stuff.
Yeah.
But what's your inspiration through it all? I mean, what inspires you? Is it a favorite film or a person or a quote that you live by?
Well, I made a deal with God a long time ago. And, you know, being from Dayton, Ohio, worked probably pretty much every job there is. And, you know, I found myself cleaning carpets one day, and I was just like, this just sucks, you know? And I was like, this cannot be what life is about. And I knew that I was an artist, and I said, well, God, you know, you gave me these talents for a reason. What do you want me to do with them? You know, and I told him, I said, you know, if you can just show me what to do, I'll do whatever you tell me to do. As long as I don't have to clean carpets and just, you know. So I literally, it was like a TV set in my head. It was just, channels was flicking. And I asked him to give me an idea. And he gave me an idea, and that was Soul of a Juggernaut, and it was just basically about depression, you know. So from then on, you know, I called Alex up. I said, hey, man, you know, let's do this movie thing. And he's like, what are you talking about, you know? So I roped him into it. You know, I knew Alex was a great storyteller, great artist and everything, but we'd never, you know, films, that was just something, like, crazy, you know? So,
yeah.
So I went to ITT, you know, learned how to edit, and, you know, we had, like, got a chance to do a short film. So we did a short film. And like I said, Alex was there. Dave wasn't in the picture quite yet, but he was down the pipeline. But once we did that one was about not having God in your life, sort of as well. But it was basically symbolic as a vampire, you know, someone that was completely atheist. But after we did that one, you know, we kind of realized that, you know, hey, this is something that we could do for a long time, you know. And even prior to that, which is kind of crazy when you look back, you know, like my dad exposed us to video cameras, editing tape to tape, creating little sets and things like that. So when I look back, I'm like, huh, maybe, you know, God already set you up, you know, he's just waiting for me to catch up. So that, you know, I think that's really the reason why I decided to do what I'm doing. And then, you know, it's been 10 plus years and people are like, you know, you're still doing it. And I'm like, well, I wasn't doing it for any other reason other than God, you know? So if he says do it, and I say I'm gonna do it, then I'm gonna do it, you know? So my plan is to die on set.
Really? Okay. Yeah. Well, hopefully that's when you're 100 years old. So with everything, you wrapped up, you know, Descent of a Superstar. That was your baby. You guys have been working on that for months.
Yeah.
Once you saw it on the big screen, you've been sending it out to different festivals, LA. I mean, you've been doing it big. Yeah. When you really see all that hard work and it's completed, what's the first thing that goes through your mind?
Well, I mean, this Descent of a Superstar was our second film that went up on the screen. Our first film was Soul of a Juggernaut, you know, so that was different. But this one, I get that question a lot. People always ask me, like, how do you feel when you see your work up there? It's just, to me, there's so many moving pieces that when I see it on film, I feel amazed that it all came together. I feel proud, but more importantly, I think that I look at all of my cast members, I look at all my crew, I see scenes and I know how many hours it took, or I look at effects and I know how many, you know, how much blood, sweat, and tears, how many days that we're staying up just on, it's crazy. So I don't really look at the finished product as a regular viewer. I'm always looking at it as, wow, you know, look what all of us did. We just put all of this hard work in and we have something that you can sit and watch, you know? So, you know, that's the way I felt. I think watching it in LA was a little different, you know? Cause it's like, it's a bigger screen. No one knows you, but when they really appreciate it and they really like it, it's just like, man, you know.
You're onto something.
Yeah, we're in Hollywood, we're in LA, you know? Which, you know, is a big deal, you know. So I'm proud. I mean, I'm definitely proud, but I think I'm more proud that the cast and the crew decided to follow me, you know, because they're all great people in themselves, you know. So if they see something in me that they say, okay, we'll start when you say action, or we'll cut when you say cut, you know, that makes me feel good that, you know, Lord willing, I'm doing them some justice as well. So yeah, I'm just proud.
Was it difficult picking your cast and crew, like getting that together? How does everyone kind of mesh? How does that come together?
Well, I mean, it's not really difficult. You know, we knew what we were looking for in every character. You know, it, like Dave said, we really put together just a well thought process, like plotted out every character. We knew what we were gonna do. It's just really trying to find the people that match those characters. Sometimes that can be a challenge, but putting it together, you know, we talked about it. I said, Dave, can you put together a casting call sheet? You know, he went ahead and hit up all the regular routes and some routes is not regular, which, you know, definitely works. And, you know, we get them in. I think, again, the hardest part is just keeping all the pieces together. You know, like anybody who does filmmaking, especially independent filmmaking, you know that there's a lot of things that fall through the cracks. You know, so the way I was brought up, you know, you got to know where the cracks are or anticipate that there's going to be a crack there and have a safety net. So, you know, I typically catch a lot of, you know, things that fall through.
That's good.
I mean, it's crazy, but, you know, we catch a lot of things, you know.
That's
and
a gift.
I have Dave and I have Alec to back me up. So, you know, I'm never in it alone. So I never feel that pressure of just, oh, you know, you better do it. You know, you better do it. So, I mean, I think that's the most difficult part, is just kind of keeping it all together. Just, you know, it's a lot of pieces.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're doing a terrific job.
Thank you.
I have enjoyed the film. I look forward to the next one. I do have a quick question, though.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure I got the words right. You don't love me, but I'm addicted to my disease. That
mm-hmm.
was a phrase in the song.
Yeah.
I was jamming to the song, like, okay. Then I started listening to the words. I'm
right.
like, that's deep. How did the song come about? And
it's top secret.
You know.
That actually, a friend of mine named Dee wrote that, and she's an amazing artist. She actually did the hair and the makeup and the wardrobe and stuff for Selena when she was a pop star and everything. So she's really talented in like all facets. But I actually had an idea. Like I said, you know, I knew Selena needed to be singing a song, and I just, you know, I came up with the hook in my head, and I was like, it reminded me of like a Chris Brown or Rihanna type, you know, like for some reason she likes to get beat up or whatever the song was. And I was just like, wow, you know, I think we all kind of go through some things where we know it's not good for us, but we still love it, you know. So in a sense, that's kind of what this film was about. She knew that this addiction would probably be the end of her, but she just loved it so much, you know. So it was kind of like that abusive boyfriend that some people just can't get enough of, you know. So that was the idea. You know, that was the idea. I sung, it's top secret. No. I sung it. It was terrible. It was terrible. But I handed it to Dee, and she was just like, oh, that's great. And she just wrote an entire song to it. And then the guy who actually did our score, which is Alex, we have like tons of Alexes on our crew. But, you know, he actually heard, you know, what she had came up with. And then he wrote the track for it. And basically everybody just got together and just did it. You know, I was just listening like, hey, that's awesome. You know, so yeah, that's kind of how the song came about.
Okay.
It's kind of that underlying tone of the film.
Yeah, I feel like that really captures the whole film into one, I guess, sentence.
Yeah, yeah.
When I heard that, I was like, oh, you know, be careful the friends you keep, the choices you make, the addictions can really have a negative impact on you.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Well done to you and your team.
Thank you.
Appreciate I look forward it. To seeing what's next.
Oh, it's gonna be a lot.
Okay, I'm ready.
You ready?
All right.
All right.
Well, thank you. Nice
thank
talking
you.
To you.
All right.
Thank you for tuning in. Make sure you check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, and website. And don't forget, don't wait for anything. Go after it. Make it happen. That's real independence.